out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Steps away to his left. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open. So it was tuck it and run time, and he picks up a first down.
From the gun, it's Wilson. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. He's at the 40, the 20, 10, and into the end zone. A pick 6 for the 49er D as they score the touchdown. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the 4th quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
In your face.
Working from the gun, Garoppolo. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. He's at the 50, 30, 20, 10, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick 2, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way.
I know they didn't tack on the 2 points, but I liked their attempt. After the interception return for a touchdown, I was thinking to myself, forget kicking it, go for 2, and they did.
Boy, yeah, and everybody's scrambling. Maybe you catch the defense on their heels. They weren't ready to be out there.
Yeah, it's almost like a sudden change, right? There's a turnover, you take it away. They stuck it in the end zone. Keep the momentum going. Give credit to the defensive guys for rallying and stopping that 2-point attempt.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right,
the ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. If the ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
To throw again on 2nd down. Wilson flushed out right. Now he'll pull it down. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a 1st down.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, 2nd half, no quit in him.
0.
Now Wilson on 1st down. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense, great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone, and especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to him.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's the Seahawks with possession of the football, but they do trail here to begin quarter number 4. They go play action here on 1st down. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because This is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
A nice job of eluding the pressure there, scrambling for 11.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
On third and goal, Wilson. It's caught. Lockett. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. A terrific job there to keep him out of the end zone. And now it'll be fourth and goal.
Completed pass brings up a fourth down situation. Do you play analytics on this one? Well, you know, what do your analytics tell you about going for it here? I wonder what they would say.
They tell me you're down by this margin, fourth quarter. You're going. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And his 49er defense stands tall down near the goal line. Well, certainly not the way that they were hoping that possession would end, failing to convert on fourth.
And now they've got to make sure that they keep their poise, they keep their confidence. Just because it didn't work once doesn't mean if they get that same situation later that they shouldn't go for it again. The defense feels great, but the offense, they can't be despondent.
And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run, and even 70 yards. We know he's good at catching the football, but then after the catch, he's got escapability.
Not only that, he's got some toughness as well, because you know he's coached very hard to make sure he battles through, breaks tackles, and then they finish with, but don't fumble the football.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stop that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So they get the takeaway, but that's just step one. They still have a lot of work to do.
But they don't want to focus on that now. Now it's about getting the ball in the end zone and hoping they can take it away again.
Yeah, still a three-score game, though, fourth quarter. Wilson, the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 13. Here's Wilson to throw. He's going to take off with it. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down. It's a gain of 17 yards. First down, Seattle. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
What we got?
To throw is Wilson. Operating from the gun. On the run, he'll let this go deep right. That's caught at the 25. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. David Moore, 69 yards. And the Seahawks are able to close the gap just a bit.
You got to understand situational football because they're playing with the lead here late in the ball game. So the back defender has got to be as deep as the deepest receiver. Keep everything in front of you, rally up and make the play.
Yeah, you would think they had the three-score lead. Now it's down to two, but three-score lead here late that they wouldn't give up a big pass play like that, but they did. This is taken at the three. And he'll weave his way up, all the way up, a few yards shy of midfield.
Now that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Tevin Coleman, 52 yards. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. Oh, I think the Niners got it back. Yes, San Fran recovers. Well, there you go. Just your everyday leading big and you onside kick it with a lead. They got it. I mean, it worked, but interesting call.
I think because they have such a margin, they feel a little bit bolder about what they're doing. And it's not only just to try and increase their lead, but that's their way of saying we're in full control of this game and we can kind of do what we want.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Unable to stop KJ right there as he slips by for the sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Well, that last sack, it puts Garoppolo and the 49ers in a tough spot. They face a third and long. On third and long, it's Garoppolo. It's caught inside the 25. A big gain of 31 on third down. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Trey Flowers picks it. And he's gonna score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. Nice pick, nice pick. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell, just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they didn't get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This fielded at the two. Dances by him. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And he's got Rome past the 20. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome. Put a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little land, yeah.
And you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. baby, tell your mama and tell your daddy. I tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. I tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons.